This morning, I was awakened about 3:15 by a phone call advising me that there had been a shooting involving LMPD and the National Guard. I took several calls from home, got to my office at about 4:30 this morning, and I've been there ever since, working and wanting to find the truth in this matter. Wanting to find the truth in a way that spoke for itself, at a time when trust is difficult and people deserve to be able to see and evaluate. And learning the circumstances originally, it was my hope that it would be as simple as pulling body camera footage so that people could see and maybe even feel what those responding saw and felt. I watched tonight the press conferences, including the Metro Council press conference in Louisville. And I think Councilwoman Paula McCraney, who used to be my councilwoman, somebody I'm very proud of. And then I think it was Councilwoman Keisha Dorsey. They both spoke. They repeated the same phrase, that enough is enough. I want them and you to know that I am listening. It is unacceptable that the officers that responded last night did not have body cameras on and recording. This is the entire reason that we have those cameras. And every other officer's camera should be reviewed, and if they captured any part of the scene, it ought to be released. It's unacceptable that Breonna Taylor's family has been apparently told it would take months to finish the rest of the investigation. These things, they are not okay. They are not okay to a commonwealth and a city and a community that is hurting, that is already concerned about one event where body cameras were not on. It's not okay. And to a community that needs to heal and certainly see great change. This was not something that we should have seen today. Here's my pledge. Through the Kentucky State Police, which has been hard at work today at the scene, we are going to investigate this matter. It is going to be done in an honest and transparent way that will not take months. Let's make sure that this family that's grieving today doesn't have to wait the months that Breonna Taylor's family has had to. Just hours ago, that her mom was right here. Trying to put into words her pain and her frustration, and also having, I guess, the strength to call for peace even in a very difficult time. I know with today, that's probably harder, but it's still something that I would ask of everybody out there. We are going to respond to this incident better. My pledge is that we will give you the truth, no matter what the truth is, no matter what it makes any group look like, just the truth. I think that's what the people of Kentucky, and that's what our hurting communities deserve, and it's what I'm going to work towards. Again, The lack of direct body camera footage is unacceptable. And I think we all feel that way. And now, our mission is to work fast, to be thorough, and to get full results so that this family can have a full accounting and the truth for what has happened. Tonight, I know that there are going to be demonstrations, at least up to the curfew. Please be safe. I know the tensions are high. I can't feel the depths of the frustration, but it doesn't change that I want everybody to be safe. I don't want anybody else to be hurt. I want to make sure that the events of last night don't happen tonight. And I know I've only been governor a short period of time, but I hope that as I work and move forward, that I will gain the trust of many who are hurting, that we will work to make the change that's needed. All right. Daniel?
You often said that enough federal people don't have body cameras on. Do you feel that there should be more consequences for
these officers? The question is, do I think there ought to be more consequences? And I don't know what the consequences are going to be yet for officers that did not turn on their body cameras. I don't know these officers. I don't know the situation. But isn't a body camera designed especially for when you are going into a crowd? And while hopefully no one ever anticipated something like this would happen, still, you know, you're going into a tense situation at a tense time. My hope is that there is other footage other than the poll cameras that we saw, footage that I pushed, though I didn't see really until anybody else did, or shortly there before, to get out. We got to release all the information on this, and it is certainly my hope that there are other footage that. I think, yes, it's very significant. I want to see the discipline that's handed out. After everything that's happened, this can happen. It shouldn't have. Joe.
Are your thoughts on the effectiveness of the curfew change at all since then?
With tensions and where they are right now, I still think a curfew protects more people, hopefully, than it concerns. I think we got to be fluid. I think we need to be talking with community leaders. I would say that with tensions high tonight, I'd ask people to demonstrate before the curfew. And if they're willing to be safe, to go home, and if they're not, to still be safe, to do, you know, everything that you can. I don't want to see anybody else hurt. I don't want this to turn into something that we've seen in either other places now or in the past. And I know that's a hard ask because I haven't felt or lived the way that those expressing their frustration have. And in the end, all I can do right now is to accept that I am unsatisfied with where things are. My commitment is a swift investigation in this, but also the hard work, you know, that lies in front of us. If this doesn't wake up our world and our Commonwealth and our country, I just don't know what will. So I believe people are listening. I certainly am. Morgan. So the question is, will the state be releasing the names of the individuals in the National Guard, and what's the process for investigation? We'll have to look at the protocol on the name piece. The investigation is being conducted by the Kentucky State Police. I want to make sure that it's independent from both LMPD and the Guard. And I want to ensure that all the evidence is collected and that everybody gets the full and the entire truth. Tom.
Governor, your thoughts changed at all from this morning on the Guard presence, so maybe you said that you'd be sending more help?
The question is, has my thinking changed on the Guard presence? I know that last night, given the circumstances, the presence of the Guard might be hard for a number of people, for a lot of people. I hear that, even if I can't feel it in the same way. But if the worst of the worst arises, things that nobody wants, if violence were to break out in a way that nobody intends, but has happened at different moments in history, I think it's important that they still have a presence, because no one would want that to occur. With that said, there are certainly going to be some different parameters going forward. There's more active monitoring directly from the Guard, and there are going to be some different instructions. I believe that that's the very least that we can do in trying to learn and react from everything that's happened. Lawrence?
Jumping off Tom's question, there are questions being asked in West Louisville about the Guard giving this forced role, why they're in that part of town in that kind of situation. What have you learned there?
The question is about the Guard being in West Louisville last night. I think there are legitimate questions that we're going to need to look at moving forward about the tactical decision to deploy to that area. Again, that wasn't the Guard's decision. That was following with LMPD in the way that structure at that point was arranged. We've got limited video right now. It certainly shows that something happened that raised significant concerns with those involved, but we have to look at the reaction. We've got to get the evidence, and we've got to figure out exactly what happened. The family of the individual who was lost deserves nothing less than the truth, and the truth, regardless of who it's hard for, is still the truth.
Obviously, you are asking for a speedy investigation at this point. How do you ensure that it does move forward the way you want to move forward? How involved will you be with that?
Well, the question is, I've called for a speedy investigation. How do we ensure that? That's the Kentucky State Police, which is a part of the executive branch of state government. Listen, I'm not going to interfere. I don't do that. But I am going to push and push to make sure that there is no delay because of our end. We've got to make sure that people get information, and that may mean that we provide updates along the way. But what I want to make sure is, when we provide an update, the information is accurate. Now, today, earlier, I didn't talk about a lot of the facts, because I think people should be able to watch and see for themselves. And I think we all agree that there should have been better footage, body camera footage, to be able to do that. And that may be a reason that people are more upset today, though I know they're already upset over the loss of someone. But that's something that shouldn't have happened. I'm committed to fixing, regardless of where it occurs. I'm upset about it. Shouldn't have happened.
Given what you have seen, do you feel like police acted appropriately? Another question about how those National Guard roads were
So the question is, did people act appropriately last night? I think, because of the lack of body camera footage, we need more information. It does appear from the footage and from the audio that the Guard and officers were shot at. And that's going to elicit a response. What we have to do is look at that response. And that's not me trying to not be supportive of anyone. That's just saying that we need to see the actual facts. The footage that LMPD did have, they released, and they should. But there should be more footage, too. Now, it's going to look at things like ballistics. It's going to involve interviews for those that were present. It's going to require a real investigation, which would have occurred before. It'll just require it without the aid, at least of the two individuals and their body cameras. My hope is that other officers had their cameras on, and we got some additional information there.
With the National Guard in that process, they're supposed to be carrying some of the equipment.
Well, no, the guard's policy, as it's been, is they carry their weapons unloaded, but they do have ammunition on them if fired upon. And so once fired upon, they load their weapons. And we still, suggesting any conclusion to what we need to do and to get that truth out. And I could understand questions people would have. At the same time, you know, individuals who are fired upon, I think people would also say need to have the means to potentially defend themselves. And we got to get to the truth of this matter, and we will.
With Mayor Greg Beshear firing the police chief today, do you feel like he needs to do anything more to kind of contain the situation with the Louisville Police Department in this regard, or do you think there's
Yeah. Question is on the mayor today and his actions in firing the police chief. Are there other things that I think need to be done? I think the mayor needs to look really hard, really hard at the situations in the Breonna Taylor case. We saw a number of Metro Council folks calling for a different conclusion. Now, I believe I have not seen that file or that investigation, but I think it requires a very close look. The situation with body cameras has to be addressed. Obviously, that falls in the chain of command of LMPD. This is something that happened twice. And again, I don't want to prejudge anything. This is also a law enforcement group that was from city that I lived in for 15 years that provided safety for me and my family. In this instance, though, I think we all can say that it's not acceptable to not have body camera footage from probably the most important vantage points. Morgan?
You mentioned that the National Guard will still be deployed in Louisville tonight, and there will be new guidelines. Are all one of those guidelines be about restricting or banning their deployment to West Louisville?
And the question is, will the new restrictions on the guard restrict movements to certain places based on what could or can't happen tonight? I don't think that we can release that information at this time, but I do want those that are concerned about last night and the decisions to know that we're listening. We're listening. Tom?
Governor, are you going to perhaps
Question is, will we ask for KSP to take over the Breonna Taylor investigation? This is one that I've already called for an independent review, and I think I was one of the first to call for an independent review of Breonna Taylor's case by the Attorney General, the U.S. Attorney, and the Commonwealth Attorney, and that needs to happen. I mean, it needs to happen. If you don't have a full file, look over what you have now and make some determinations whether you have sufficient information or not. Department of Justice in Washington, D.C., we need to hear from. My understanding is that's now with their Civil Rights Division because our U.S. attorney recused himself. We need to hear directly from them. This is a family that's hurting. And they're hurting because of the loss of their daughter. They're also hurting because they believe they haven't gotten information, maybe even a response. And I know that they want a response that is one of justice and a vindication, but a response is needed.
You said that investigation into not being fair should not take months. Any idea the timeline as far as the
Well, I know the question is the timeline of the investigation of what happened. You know, I guess it was today, early this morning on the timeline. I don't have a specific timeline yet, but I know it's moving. I know that there should be significant amounts of evidence. We're not going to hold anything in this one. We're going to move as quickly as we can because I believe in the people of Louisville. I believe in the people of Kentucky. And I believe that if we are honest with them about the things that occur, that it's the right thing to do. And not being transparent, always makes things worse. So my understanding is they're already off to a significant start. I know we had three on the scene today. I believe it may have grown to five by the end, though I'll need to confirm that. But we're going to use significant resources, and I'm not going to let a lack of resources hold the investigation up. I've got the commitment of the commissioner on that. He knows the importance of this, especially in light of where the community is tonight. I know that some have lost faith, and I hope they haven't lost faith in me. And I'm going to push this as hard and as fast as I can, while still giving them the ability to do their work, to not interfering. This is a group that does this on a daily basis around the state. I think they are the right ones to do it. And I believe that they know that my charge is we're just going to find the truth.
I spoke to Mayor Beshear, and how did that conversation go? And also, do you think there should be more accountability also on city leadership?
I've spoken to Mayor Fisher a number of times. You know, he's dealing with a tough situation, and I believe he's trying to make the right decisions in his mind. And that doesn't mean that I agree with all of them, but my hope is I know that he. Well, I'm back. I know who Greg Fisher is. And I know the last thing he wants is the situation as it's unfolding right now. I think today you saw him get emotional and try to give voice to the loss, especially last night. His firing of the chief, I think, shows that a step is being made, but listen, people are upset, and they should be. I know they're upset for what happened to Breonna Taylor. They're upset with what's happening in America. They're upset with a video out of Minneapolis and one out of Georgia that are absolutely unacceptable. People shouldn't have to live, you know, watching that in fear or terror. I said earlier today, I've only known what that's like for a day or a week. It's not the same what I experienced. Not at all. People deserve so much better. You know, our society, certainly our African American community, deserves so much better. And my hope is that we will see real, lasting societal change. And this isn't just another moment where we think it's going to happen. I hope this is the moment that it actually happens. All right, we'll do one more. One more.
Do you think Mayor Fisher can agree to being the community at this point should be resolved?
I think Mayor Fisher will work to regain the trust of the community. I believe he's going to be openly and actively communicating with leaders across the community.
A lot of people have pointed out the differences in responses from police regarding the protests here at the Capitol and the government mentioned compared to what they're doing in Louisville. Can you kind of speak to the differences there?
Sure. You know, the question is, there seems to be a difference between reactions of protests here at the governor's mansion and what's going on in Louisville. Well, folks, I hope you all know that I certainly don't approve of that group armed walking directly up onto the patio of where I raise my kids. I don't approve. You know, the fact is when people are engaging in intimidating behavior, which they were, in an effort to cause fear or terror, I don't approve of the way that things were handled that day here in Frankfort. Tom?
Governor, you've had to deal with the coronavirus. You've had to deal with the folks outside your home.
Yeah.
You've been dealing with this. I mean, how does this affect any of the shootings?
Question is, you know, between the coronavirus and what happened here on the Capitol grounds and the rest, I think the question is, how am I doing? I think, you know, Ricky Jones said it in his column, I'm going to be all right. These things that I'm dealing with are temporary. The call to leadership on COVID-19 is something I'm going to do, and we're going to do the right things. What others expressing their frustration in Louisville the last several nights have been dealing with is so much more significant, based on hundreds of years of discrimination, of segregation, of slavery. I just, and my hope and my prayer is that when I say I'm listening and I'm trying to hear, that people believe me and give me that opportunity. Because if my mark as governor maybe isn't what I thought it probably would be, which is dealing with COVID-19, but is instead helping to usher in real societal change, that's something that I want to try to do. Morgan.
I know you stressed that you asked the state police to investigate more than the insurance dependent. I think there is a perception out there that, you know, police officers feel they're banding together across agencies. Why do people should trust that, and that the state police team will be able to be objective and independent about investigating, you know, especially that involve people who are fellow police officers, even if they're not technically colleagues?
Now, the question is, why do I believe that there will be true independence in the investigation of the Kentucky State Police? This group, this is what they do. They analyze these shootings all over the state. KSP investigates, other than just a handful of places, these all over the state. I think there have been instances where they have found that things shouldn't have happened. And in an investigation, you know, you collect all the evidence ought to speak for itself. You just got to be transparent with that evidence and not holding it back and trusting the people of Kentucky. If it looks bad, you still show it to them. They deserve the truth, and I'm going to make sure that happens. But that KSP unit, this commissioner are committed to it. I've been talking to them all today. Multiple times today. I think they didn't need me to say it, but that we're going to get this right. We're going to let people know the truth. We're going to truly seek justice. It's something we've been talking about, you know, all day long.
Lawrence. You talked about the mayor, who will be here being the trust of the Louisville residents. Was the department the chief has come in that direction? Did he do the right thing?
I believe at this point that Chief Conrad, who's somebody I've known, and as a nice individual, it had to happen. It had to happen. You know, when you're governor, sometimes you have to say things about people that you think are nice people, but it had to happen. Two incidences of this significance. No body cameras. It had to happen. It was the right move. Last one. Well, my hope, that question was the firing of the police chief. What message should it send to people who are protesting tonight? My hope is the message that people are hearing is steps are being taken, not just in the termination of the police chief, the creation of the Citizen Review Board. We heard from Paula McCraney today. Again, my former Metro Councilwoman, that she is going to ensure an independent Citizen Review Board. And I hope people here tonight that I think that some of the facts that have just come out are not acceptable. They're not acceptable to the governor of the Commonwealth of Kentucky. They are not acceptable, whether they're here in Frankfort or in Louisville. And that I think before people can have trust that we will work for change, they've got to see that things make you mad too. I know not in the same way, and it can't be for the same depth, but people need to know and that you're committed to doing what's right. You know, when we came into office, I had a commitment, and my commitment was to to do what we could, and you saw us take steps like voting rights and Medicaid, rolling back the waiver, being really intentional in our hiring. But we're at a different moment now, where we got to aim for a whole lot more. We got to see something entirely different moving forward than we do right now. You know, COVID-19 and what was already happening showed us that we are at a point in time where our world and our country and our state are going to look different moving forward. They're going to look different no matter what. This is one of those pauses in time, whether it was the Great Depression, World War II, or other moments where there is a new America that comes out of it. Well, right now, people are calling out for a new America that is just, that finally stops some of the oppression or racism or segregation of the past. If we are at a moment for a new America, this ought to be one of the things that we demand to happen coming out of it. I will pledge to work for that, no matter what it means for me politically. Oh, during this pandemic, I've been saying I'm done with politics, and I mean it. Now, there's so much happening, but it gives us an opportunity to be better. You know, we talked about being better neighbors, and we need to be a heck of a lot better neighbors to communities that haven't been treated like neighbors. So now is kind of a moment in history, right here and right now, independent from everything that's going on in COVID-19. And the question is, are we going to grasp it, make real change, listen, ensure we are hearing, give voice to the frustration, the fatigue, give an opportunity for a mom of someone that's been in this situation to speak here instead of me? Now, I think now is a chance to get things right. And I hope those tonight can believe in that sincerity and can give us that opportunity. Everybody, please be safe. Tensions are high. I don't want anybody to get hurt, anybody. We can work together. I believe it's possible. We can do it right here in Kentucky. We talked about doing that in COVID, but we can do it right here in Kentucky. A long time ago, Kentucky became the first Southern state to sign a Civil Rights Act. And our history hadn't been very good since then. Maybe now's the time to change that, and I'm committed to it. Thank you all very much.